everyone, I'm Will, and today we are going to look at wild radishes and how to identify them compared to common radishes. But before that, remember to like and subscribe and comment down below, and don't forget to press that notification bell down below.
And an easy, simple way to look at the difference between a flowering wild radish and a flowering cultivated radish is right here. This is the wild radish, and over here is the cultivated radish. The identification that you're looking for is right here with the flowers, how they are shaped, nice and yellow, small buds, and the leaves, they're a little bit more serrated on the leaves, a little bit more sharper, and on the bottom of the leaf there's a bit more of hairs than most the radishes. If we look right over here with the radish, there's also hairs on this. With the flowering stalk, you want to look at the size of the plant. So this will grow a little taller. This is already about 2 feet tall. And the flowers are gonna be about, when they're bloomed, about 4 millimeters in width. Flowers, they're going to be larger, about 3 times to 4 times larger than the wild variety. With any species of radish versus the wild and the cultivated, you can use them just like broccoli. Broccoli is in the same family as mustard, and radishes are in the mustard family. And also right here, we got some kale. That's a mustard too. So if this is mustard of wild radish, it can lower cholesterol. All mustards can help lower cholesterol. So with the cultivated radish has a slight spicy flavor compared to a little bit spicier than broccoli raw. The wild radish, if you eat the flower buds off of that, is going to be more of a flavor like horseradish. And horseradish is also a mustard in a dish using a good quantity, but the wild radish you want to use just as a seasoning to not overwhelm your palate. This is what the roots look like. With the cultivated one, you have that red bulb. For the wild one, it's going to have a white root. The spines on the underside of the leaf, and there's spines on the stalk of it. The ones on the cultivated radish are going to be larger, about twice as large as the wild radish. With identifying by the spines on the radishes, the cultivated radish, the spines on it are going to be somewhere to 1 to 2 millimeters in length. And on the wild radish, the spines are going to be about 0.5 millimeter to 1 millimeter in length, so half the size. With all radishes, where the leaf is, the leaf node is, there's going to be more likely on every single one, same with the wild ones, there's going to be a flowering stalk. So same with the wild ones. So there's going to be a lot of flowers forming from both. That you're doing a wild dish, you want that horseradish flavor, go with the wild radish. If you just want a strong, like spicy broccoli rob, go with the flowering stalk of the cultivated radish. A good characteristic of what you're looking for of a wild radish versus a cultivated radish, the cultivated radish will have one single flowering stalk. The wild radish will have a flowering stalk with the leaves from the basal rosette. And that is how you identify and tell the difference of wild radish versus cultivated radish and what to do with it. If you want to see more, go down in the description below, click the link to my channel, or press the round subscribe button to help me out to get to 1,000 subscribers. And until next time, remember to get outside, get fresh air, and have fun. See ya.